Hello, it's me again, and this time I would really like to talk about blending hydrogen alpha and RGB data. This is what happened. I shot this image and I like it because I think it looks like a dark world, and then I decided to add hydrogen alpha data to this RGB so it looked like this, and I think it gives more contrast and you see the world way better than before. This is how that image looks, and I like my star color. I like the contrast on the red from hydrogen alpha, and you know, just like it, that's it. But how to blend hydrogen alpha and RGB data on Astropixel processor? Well, this is what I did. I have my files. These are the resulting stacks of the red channel, green channel, blue channel, and hydrogen alpha of the same target. And I opened Astropixel processor. I will set up my work directory as the one where I have my files. It's called Dark Wolf. And I'm going to untick auto detect masters and integrations. I need it. What happened is I want to create a synthetic luminance with this file. So if I don't untick this, it won't see these files as lights. So I will select all my files and I will show you how they look. This is my hydrogen alpha data. All right, this is my red, my green, and my blue. So the first thing I'm gonna do, these files are already registered and ready to work with them, but what happened is I found that if you make a synthetic luminance, it helps when you blend them to balance all the colors and get somewhere where I want to be. So what I do, I just go with these results. I go right to the integrate tab and I just hit integrate and wait a little bit. It doesn't take too long until Astropixel processor stacks all those images and gives me what you might call a synthetic luminance. Once I do this, what happens is I will combine these images, all these channels, into one image, and you'll see the result. And that's how I ended with that photo that I like. So hopefully you like it. Mabula has a video of blending HA with RGB, but he does it in a galaxy shot. This galaxy shot, then you see how this hydrogen alpha pops up, all these details on the galaxy. This is a bit different because this is the complete image is full of hydrogen. So I will show you this last file is my synthetic luminance, as you can see. It combines data from all of the previous files. And what I'm gonna do is go to Tools, Combine RGB, right? Combine RGB. And I will add, for example, let me show you. If I add RGB, I will tell Astropixel processor, yeah, blue is blue. That's right. Green is green. And then red is red. Perfect. That's good. All right. If I, as an exercise, if I calculate this image, I will get the result I showed before. All right. It looks a bit dark in here. Then I need to show you a bit of stretching there. And that's what I had on the image before. But it happens that I can add this hydrogen alpha data. Sorry, let's add first the luminance data, which is this one, and I will tell Astropixel processor this is luminance, and the whole image will pop up. Boom. That's my my wolf, all right? But I would really like to use data from my hydrogen to give more contrast, more red into that. It's not bad, but I think I can do a bit better yet. So I will do the trick and add the hydrogen alpha. And I will tell APP this is hydrogen alpha. And this is where the difference comes. I have, as you can see, this is the blue data, the green data, and the red data. This is our luminance. Let me show you something. The luminance, as you see the sliders here, this increases this channel's effect on red. This increases this channel's effect on green, as you can see the G. And this one for B, the blue. And this case, because it's luminance, it's the contribution, it's on the luminance channel. On the red, red is 100%. On the green, green is 100%. Blue, it's 100%, okay? The blue channel. It happens that now we are adding hydrogen alpha. And of course, we want to put hydrogen alpha on red, for example. So if I move this forward, look at this. It's on zero at the moment. If I move it all the way to 100%, the total contribution of this channel will be 50%, okay, on the image. And the red channel will contribute only 50% to the image. And I will click calculate to see the effect of what I just did. Okay, so I have a bit more red in there. Don't worry about the color balance, we'll fix that later. All right, this data is, of course, it's getting all moved around, but we'll fix it soon. Okay, so if I want to bring this data, okay, if I want to have more reds, so I will just get, can you see these top slider? It's like a multiplier for the channel. Let's make it 1, 3, 4, 6 and hydrogen alpha 1, 3, 4, 6. And we calculate here. So we have more red in there. Okay. Don't worry about the base green you see there. We're going to get rid of that later. And we can play with the data to see what happens. Not every data set works the same. I have heard of people that when they combine hydrogen, they want to put a bit of blue on the mix. And in this case, it's as simple as just saying, I want hydrogen alpha to give 50% to blue, and the total contribution will be 33%. And I can just calculate and see what happens on the image. Maybe it's worse, maybe it's better. But it turns the red into a purple. Personally, that's not what I'm after. So I just kick it back, calculate again. Right? It happens that I can change what happens with luminance. Let's say, that will show you. If I put the luminance in 1.5, this is the effect of the luminance channel. Okay? If I back up a little, this is the effect of the luminance channel. Okay, I like the tone of the red I'm having behind the color stars, and if you have a look, you have all your RGB stars are there, all beautiful RGB stars. Some stars, the colors are way off because the whole color balance is off. As you can see on my spikes, the rainbow, you can see the rainbow clearly, but it's just there. So what I will do with this, it's I will just save it, create that file, click OK, and get out of here, scroll down in my little list in there, and I will have this combined RGB image. So let's work with this image a little. first thing I do is I want to get rid of this stuff. This is because my RGB were in a different angle than my HA data. So I would just click rotate resize. I will flip these two axes, show me what the result is. So I want to see my wolf the way I want to frame it. That's correct, that's there, and that's my big stars. I believe even when it's a lot of red on the image, these stars and the stars in the image are balancing the rest of the colors. You can rotate a little bit here, clockwise, counterclockwise. I want to rotate counterclockwise. Let's have a look at 3 degrees. Show me that. I want to get this line straight in the bottom so I can crop it. Something like that. Let me go 2. Just a little bit. So I can crop the most of the image and have it. Yeah, I just leave it like that. Say yes. Click OK. So now that I have the image there, I can go to batch modify and I will crop the image I want. So let's see, I can just choose what I need. Let's see what that bottom corners, top corners, so good. So here what I do, I just click crop OK, click OK, and the file that I want is this one. Should be this one. Yes. So now, how do I get rid of this green color? I could clean this up in Photoshop easy by desaturating green, but I prefer to clean these gradients or whatever happened there with Astropixel processor. And remember these steps, remove light pollution and calibrate background. It happens that in this new version, every time you remove light pollution, it calibrates the background in one step. So I was corrected by Mabula last time. So let's remove light pollution. I click yes. Theory says I have to make little test boxes where there is no nebula, but it, as you can see, it's a bit challenging because it's nebula everywhere. Let's see the effect of these test boxes in this data. I can click calculate and see what the system does. So to understand what the system's doing, as you can see, it gave me a nice field of hydrogen alpha and my star colors there. This is what's removing from my image. All that color cast that you see there, greenish, bluish stuff, it's being pulled out of the image. Same way as a flat gets subtracted from light. And this is how my photo looks like now. Okay, I can just click OK and save because I like it. Save it. Yeah, save it all. And now I have an image with better contrast on my hydrogen alpha. And I have all my star colors. So now I can, if I want, increase saturation there, right? And as you can see, my reds are popping out, my blues are coming out beautiful, and I can use this data as is, or I can just bring it to Photoshop and just do my tweaks. I always check what happens with other stretch levels, how it balances my image, what am I pulling out, what am I saturating. I also can play with my sharpness here and check how it looks, and then protect a bit of the stars in there. So this image, I like how it looks. It's really nice. It's a lot of data in there, almost no background, because everything is mostly hydrogen alpha, and then you have here dark nebula in front of it, so I think it's really nice. Last step I do, as soon as I have it like this with all my star core popping out, saving here, my image, name it Dark World. I save it as TIFF. Whatever you choose there, I don't see much of a difference. Sorry, but I don't know the difference between them. And in here, I will go 16 bits because I'm gonna work with it on Photoshop. So once it finished, save the photo. I go to my folder, and this is my image. I can right click, open with Photoshop. And this is where I try to pop out more reds on the hydrogen alpha, keep my color or increase the contrast of the color in my stars, and do the rest. As you know, not all the data looks the same. I have a lot of beautiful filters I apply, and I just go about checking what works and what doesn't work on my data. Let's see what this does. No, no. Somewhere there, yeah. And then I let's see if this does something nice. Oh, you know what? Let's see something. Image adjustments. A lot of people has different ways of doing things in Photoshop. Photoshop is not my strong suit. But a lot of the things I have learned in Photoshop is only by making mistakes and trying to fix my mistakes. So if anyone has suggestions on how to do this better, I would all ears, I want to learn more. So this is it. This is how I blend hydrogen alpha data with RGB. And look, my RGB data is there. My hydrogen alpha is bringing out my dark wolf. And that's what I wanted. Thank you so much, and hope this useful. Bye-bye.